Bétaillé et moi, nous étions convaincus qu'il fallait viser une famille d'Airbus.
10 years after the A300's first flight saw the birth of the A310, followed a year later by the A300-600. Three aircraft built on the same basis and forming a family, an aircraft family, the Airbus trademark. A course from which Airbus has never wavered in the way it sees its role and involvement in the aviation sector, where, step by step, it would eventually become the leader. The A300 made its mark in history by introducing numerous innovations that rapidly became aviation standards, such as the wide body, allowing freight and passenger transport to be combined. The wide body would be renewed for all the future twin aisles that Airbus was to launch later, right up to the very recent A340-500 and 600. Other examples are the two-man cockpit and the first fly-by-wire tests. Airbus took advantage of the A300's exceptional capacities to establish innovations that would leave their mark on civil aviation for a long time to come. Whilst the A300 and its small family was satisfying more and more airlines, and the A300-600 was becoming a benchmark in the freight transport market, Airbus continued to be imaginative and audacious by creating new aircraft. Each, in its own way, was the result of the countless technological and industrial innovations introduced on the A300. The A300 could be proud of its descendants. Some even took on totally unprecedented features, especially two incredible aircraft, the A300-0G, designed for parabolic flights and dedicated to microgravity experiments, and the Beluga, an outsized cargo freight version of the A300-600, which would quickly become an essential element in Airbus's industrial success. Having delivered 821 aircraft, Airbus brought its first industrial program to an end, but will continue after-sales support for aircraft still in service until 2050. In 2007, while making the last adjustments, the last assembly, and of course, the last delivery, we realize all that Airbus owes today to the first of its aircraft. A300, an aircraft which will always symbolize the Airbus way.
La coopération européenne, l'idée de l'Europe et de faire un travail en européen était une idée qui levait au fond les obstacles irrationnels. Et sur le plan rationnel, ben, on arrive à s'entendre.
C'était l'imagination, mais pas que notre imagination, pas que l'imagination des ingénieurs. L'imagination des vendeurs, l'imagination enfin des commerciaux, l'imagination aussi et le courage industriel.
On a quand même l'impression qu'on a vécu une aventure formidable parce qu'on a, on a créé quelque chose qui n'existait pas. Qui n'existait pas.
Something that did not exist before. A pioneer's dream. The dream of a few Europeans who decided to cooperate to build an aircraft. And with it, this extraordinary industrial and human success that we all know. A saga. The Airbus saga.